So there was this guy, weird looking, wore a red tie. Said, man, you should be doing YouTube videos. You've got the knowledge, you've got the skill. I put it off for ages, but somehow I'm here now. This is Mentski's Video Game Graveyard. Mentski people say to me, why aren't there more games featuring bomb-throwing pigs? After looking at them strangely for a couple of seconds, I tell him these things that I am going to tell you right now. Let me take you back to 1987. Between arcade releases of legendary games such as R-Type, Contra, Afterburner and Shinobi, lesser-known developer Jaleco, responsible for games like City Connection, released this little gem called Butasan, or Pigs and Bombers in its incredibly limited Western release. You had control of a pig who would have to kill other pigs by throwing bombs littered about the play area. Think of it as Bomberman with all the walls removed.
To help you in this porcine carnage, there was a bevy of power-ups. A bottle of milk would let you throw further, a rucksack would let you carry more bombs at once. A can of sleeping gas would make your pig don a gas mask and put the rest of the pigs to sleep for a short time, and a bomb-proof Godzilla suit that makes you invincible for a short period. After every three stages, you will get a timed whack-a-mole style bonus round, where you have to kick the pigs that come out of the holes in the ground.
It's a simplistic game, but its personality shines through. Every enemy pig has its own personality, which is introduced via a rogue's gallery at the start of every round.
This little guy is Blues. As you can see, he's a bit of a coward, and here's me sticking several pounds of high explosive right up his arse. Here's Greeny. He likes sitting back, relaxing, long strolls on the beach, and oh dear, that's going to leave a mark. And I can't believe I'm saying this, but here's Blackie.
Don't fuck with Blackie. Never fuck with Blackie. Whilst Butasan's Western release was severely limited, it did get a home computer release via US Gold in the UK. Here it is. For some reason, they called it Psycho Pigs UXB.
Yeah, and US Gold used every trick in the book to hype up this game, as you can see from this two-page ad that ran in magazines back in the day. I know which one I'd rather play with, yes, but have you seen the reviews for Psycho Pigs UXB? Well, yeah, I have, as a matter of fact. Crash gave it 70%, Sinclair User gave it 59%, and the Games Machine gave it 52%. Oh dear.
Video game reviewers are idiots though. There's absolutely nothing wrong with this game. In fact, it was pretty damn faithful to the source. So if you can find a copy, either legitimately or via a corrupt uncle, I suggest you give it a go. It's full of all the fun and chaos that you need once in a while. Much like serial murder. Well, if you'll excuse me, I've got the remains of a prostitute keeping in the fridge and I've got to deal with it. Until next time, bye bye.